Welcome to Fort Lee Burneson's 26th Annual Blue and Gray Cotillion. It is my honor to present your hostesses for the evening, Allison Hope, Gia Catanzaray, and Lydia Children.
In the tradition of the military cotillions of the Civil War, our participating classmates Civics teacher, John Thompson, who devoted over 35 years to the students at Lee Burneson Middle School before retiring in 2006.
The poetry contest is named in his honor. Students were asked to consider a picture called The Widow, showing a woman in black mourning garb kneeling next to the headstone of a Confederate soldier, while the ghostly image of the dead soldier hovers next to her, offering quiet and solace.
The winner of the poetry contest is Gabrielle Kim.
Amy Hislin. And Ian Meter.
grandmother. Who will find a girl like this? Beginning of age, ending of age, ever changing, mentally, physically, as we continue to learn in many ways. Including for people who meet along the way, and how we handle the challenges we will face in life. Maybe we have been touched by those challenges, but rather how we handle those challenges. There have been many occasions in my life, many of them have surprises. I'm sure that no one back in my home state of Kentucky would have predicted that one day I would be president of these United States. Always tall as a young man, always angry, and always trying to read books. Back then, I had the strength to do hard work, but somehow I never had the inclination. My father, I always said, taught me how to work hard, but he never did teach me how to like it. I'd say I was a farmer, but frankly, I spent more time cutting down trees and digging up stumps than I ever did farming. My family moved to Indiana when I was 9, where I continued my labor duties. While I was in school as best I could, I attended some here, some there, some again. I was telling people I attended school by the rules. Altogether, I guess I might have maybe one full year of what would be called formal education. Most of what I learned in life, apart from experiences, came from books. And if you think about it, in that respect, I had some of the greatest teachers in the world. It was in Indiana at age 21, I decided to leave farming, such as it was, and try railroading. A friend and I took a river barge down the mighty Mississippi, loaded with hogs and vegetables, to that great city of New Orleans. You can imagine what that city looked like to two farm boys. We saw sights that we had never seen before. And then we saw a slave market. Men, women, and children being auctioned off as if they were horses and cattle. There is nothing that is not wrong with slavery. If it is not wrong, then nothing is wrong. There is no justice unless there's justice for everyone. I vowed then to myself that I would do whatever I could in life to end slavery. All this thing, for any reason, is wrong. My family next moved to Illinois. I first settled in New Salem, where I partnered in a general store. Our store was also the post office, and I was the postmaster. You might say that was my first federal job. Later, after I moved to Springfield, up the road a bit, I ran for the state legislature, losing my first attempt, and then winning the next time, serving 3 terms. I was also very briefly in the Black Hawk War as part of a militia. About 6 weeks, nothing to brag about. The man I was with elected me captain. I felt so proud. I had no idea what a captain was supposed to do. That was my first leadership position, though, and my only military experience until I became commander-in-chief many years later. I then became a lawyer, practiced, and then in 1846 I was elected to Congress, serving only 1 term by prior arrangement. I thought then my political career was over. I married Mary Todd in 1842, and over the next few years we proceeded to have 4 sons. I worked hard at lawyering, riding the circuit from town to town, representing those involved in various activities involving the law. I was happy as a lawyer. I would have been content to remain one, even someday becoming a judge. But when Congress replaced the law that kept slavery, confined to the South, I could not sit by and watch that happen. That would mean that slavery could be expanded to all new states. I had to do what I could to stop it. I became a candidate for Senate in 1858. The debates I had with the other candidates, Stephen Douglas, made me a national figure. I was nominated for the presidency in 1860, running against that same Douglas. I was a candidate for saving the Union and against the expansion of slavery. I won that election, as you know, and the country almost immediately became a part. It began to come apart as we went to war with ourselves. Now that as this terrible war nears the end, we can begin to look to the future, to better days of building rather than destroying. One nation without slavery. All of my life, many days, with different jobs and responsibilities, as a single man, a married man, and father made me the man I am today. Thus, as your life phases will someday make you the person you will become. Every phase can teach you something. I advise you to learn from it. For those of you in uniform here tonight, your next phase will be going to war. While your ladies, wives, and close friends stay behind to tend to family and homestead, some of these good ladies will also serve in tending to the wounded at battle sites and in hospitals. We cannot thank all of you for your sacrifices. On November 19, 1863, I had the opportunity in helping to dedicate the cemetery in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, for those who gave their lives in that horrible Let me hear how this resolve, let me stand out my divine reign. Let this nation under God shall have a number of freedom. And that government of the people, by them, for them, shall not perish from this earth. Thank you very much.
Shoulder up.
our final set of Virginia Reel dancers for this evening. Will the second set of Virginia Reel dancers please take the floor?
Thank you.
place a rose of honor at various sites along their trip.
This is a prestigious honor, and we wish to recognize them at this time. Please come forward when your name is called. Maya Akers, Katie Thomas, Johnny Kirschnick, Michael Tidwell, Avi Kokosakis,
Sammy Nickel, Manette Shake, Sam Harbaugh, Jane Brothers, and Chloe McKenna.
Thank you.
if your soldier was younger than 25. Please be seated.
Stand if your soldier survived the war or mustered out with the rest of his unit when their enlistment time was up. Please sit. Please stand if your soldier was killed in battle. You may be seated.
Please stand if your soldier served in the infantry. Please be seated.
Please stand if your soldier served in the cavalry. Please stand if your soldier served in the artillery. Please be seated.
Please stand if your soldier died in a hospital. Please be seated.
Please rise if your soldier was captured. Please be seated. Please stand if your soldier died in a prison camp. You may be seated.
Please stand if your soldier was wounded. You may be seated.
Rise if your soldier was discharged from the Army on a surgeon's certificate of discharge. Please be seated. Please stand if your soldier died during the Civil War, whether in battle, as a result of an accident, while captive in a prison camp, or while in the hospital, and please remain standing as we symbolically honor the fallen.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us this evening. You're invited to visit the Civil War Museum and the Media Center. Those students joining us for dinner may pick up your seating assignments on the table at the south entrance of the cafeteria.
At this time, you are dismissed.
So I'm here with?
My name is Richard Garber. I am general in the Army of Northern Virginia.
He said it's a pretty special role.
In fact, it is. I get to lead the march to the food.
That's a pretty noble cause right there. A hungry man is a non-working man. A satisfied man is a?
Is a working man who will defeat the Yankees and get multiple hats placed on his face.
That's dedication right there. So what would you say your favorite part of the Civil War ball was?
My favorite part was when the drill team came on and we did the guard cavalry guard. Whenever a cavalry charges you, it is very difficult to stave off. So knowing these types of maneuvers will help us in our march to the food.
All right, so tell me, what was your favorite part of the entire ball?
Probably the dancing, I would say.
Which one, the waltz or the Virginia reel?
The Virginia reel.
Were you a part of it?
Yes.
How nice. And also, how much fun did you have here?
A lot of fun, a lot more than I thought I would have.
Would you do this again if you had a chance to?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm thankful for your time, Ben.
Hi, Mom.
Can you tell us about the history of the Civil War Ball?
Yes, actually, this is my sixth year at Burneson, but the Civil War Ball has been going on for 26 years. So we've hosted it every year, and it's been great, at least the 6 years I've been here.
And do you have a favorite part of the ball?
I think it's so nice to see the kids dressed up and taking such pride in their dancing. Really, they just do such a great job. I'm so proud of them this evening.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, I'm here with?
Andrew.
So, Andrew, what rank are you?
I am a seventh rank.
Seventh rank? What would that be?
A colonel.
Good job, good job. All right, what was your favorite part about the Civil War Ball?
When Abraham Lincoln spoke to us.
Was it really inspirational?
Yes, sir.
Was it more the beard or the top hat?
Beard.
Always got to go with the beard. Oh, yeah. Would you, if you could pick any side, be Confederate or Union?
I think I'd have to go with the Union.
But look at you right here.
Well, this is
what is this? Your turncoat? What are you doing?
No, I'm actually LeBron James.
So what's your name?
I'm Jessica
Barrett.
Hey, Jessica, what was your favorite part of the ball?
Probably the bugling.
Yeah, that was nice, too. And I'm assuming you had a lot of fun, didn't you?
Yeah. It was pretty cool.
Okay. And would you do this again if you had a chance to?
Yeah, probably. It's pretty cool.
So again, thank you very much, Jessica.
All right.